रीनल सिस्टम हिस्टोपैथोलॉजी, वी विल बी डिवाइडिंग इट इनटू टू पार्ट्स, ओके? सो लेट अस स्टार्ट. फर्स्ट वी फर्स्ट स्टार्ट विद यूरिन माइक्रोस्कोपी. नाउ दिस क्वेश्चन इज समथिंग मोर यूजफुल फॉर योर university examinations, as in case of VIVAs, when you have, we all know that there is one urine mic experiment in the practical examination, and you are not going to be asked to demonstrate these crystals and casts that we see in urine, but you may be asked to draw them on your answer sheet, right? So let us start. So as we know, for this like this first image, try to identify this. Okay, first I'll tell you there are three things that are mainly seen in a urine microscopy. One is cells, second is cast, and third is crystals. Right? We will learn each of them. First, try to identify what is this. Just give a wild guess. At least try to answer whether it is a cell, whether it is a cast, or whether it is a crystal. See, the more you keep it as an interactive session, you will answer, you will learn, right? So wrong, right, whatever you feel, answer it. Okay, so correct. This is a cast. What is this? This is specifically a hyaline cast that is most commonly seen in case of urine microscopy. This is a normal phenomena. That is, in normally also in urine, we get these casts, which is called as hyaline cast. Okay, what are they made up of? They are made up of TAM horsefall proteins. TAM horsefall proteins, right? Okay, so how are they produced? That is our first question. We know that this is the glomerulus, this is the nephron, this is the glomerulus. Now in the nephron we have the conducting tubules are there, right? Just a minute. We know that the conducting tubules are there. What is the shape of these conducting tubules? They are cylindrical, right? So these tubules secrete the TAM horsefall proteins, right? And when they get excreted out into the urine, they form these hyaline casts, right? So basic understanding, these are hyaline casts made of TAM horsefall protein. They are normally found in the urine and produced by the tubular interstitium or the tubules of the nephron. Okay, next. Okay, try to identify this. What is this? You can zoom in your screen if you want to get a clear image of it. Again, I'll say, what? Give a wild guess whether it's a cast, crystal, cell, whatever you like to say. See, I'm getting where I'd answer. That is the reason. So if you will answer, you will come to know that where are you getting wrong or where are you right. Okay, so basically I have got different answers. Someone is saying crystal, someone is saying granular cast, someone is saying cast. Okay, see, when we have a cast may be of different types. It may be a waxy cast, granular cast, etc. So what do we define it? How do we define it? See, if a cast is having anything embedded on it, any cells embedded on it, and it gives a granular appearance, it is called as a granular cast. What may be the cells that may be embedded on it? It may be RBC, it may be WBC, epithelial cells, squamous cells, etc., anything. So there are various types of granular cast. Okay, this is not a crystal. See, crystal will be something very different, which I'll show you, and then you will understand that how is this different from a cast. So what is this? This is your RBC cast. Okay, how do we see? See, you can see that there are highly granular, there are a lot of granular appearances there, and they are circular in shape. You may confuse this with WBC granules, right? So WBC cast and RBC cast might be in the initial stages a problem for you all, but when you will see the WBC cast, you will understand that the RBC cast are having high granularity. There are a lot of RBCs that are attached to a single cast. While if we see the WBC cast, the main function of the WBC cast is engulfing any structure. So if this is any bacteria, any other cell, or any foreign material which it wants to engulf, the WBC cast will surround it completely. Right? Moreover, the density of WBC casts will be less as compared to RBC. More number of RBCs, remember it in an easy way, we have more of RBCs and less of WBCs. So RB, in a crystal, if there are more number of cells that are seen, sorry, in a cast, if there are more number of cells that are seen, it is an RBC cast. While if less number are seen and they appear to be surrounding any particular structure or enclosing them, it is a WBC cast. See, so here you can see in this RBC cast, high granularity. See the number of cells in a cast as compared to a WBC cast, right? This is also another cast of WBC. This white blood cell cast suggests an acute pyelonephritis condition, right? So we know that in any condition of kidney where there is infection, WBC cast will be seen in case of urine. So here also you may assume that these are not something that is secreted by the tubular interstitial cell as such. It appears that they are surrounding any central structure. They are aggregating, right? So this is a basic difference between RBC cast and WBC cast. Not these things are not generally asked in examinations. Now, next question. Try to identify what is this. Cell cast crystals. Again, at least this much. Tried to identify. Okay, so everyone is answering cells. Can anyone say which type of cell is this? Someone is saying cast. Yes, it might be a cast also. Can you be specific that what kind of cast or what kind of cell can it be? A more specific answer. Which type of epithelial cell? Yes, correct. This is a squamous epithelial cell. See, in this you can see these are cells with nuclei in center. Crystals or cast, they are acellular structures. They won't have any nucleus in center. This is a typical cell that can be seen. Now, what are the cells that can be present in a urine sample? One is squamous epithelial cells, right, arising from the urinary tract. And second is transitional epithelial cells from the urinary bladder, right? Here we can see that the cells are flat. We know that the squamous cells are fat with a central nuclei. They may be of any shape, but they are basically flat with central nuclei. So from this, we can say that these are squamous epithelial cells. These are also found normally. RBC and WBC are not found normally, but hyaline cast and squamous epithelial cells may be found normally in a urine sample. Okay. Now, there are two things in this slide. What are the two things which you can see? Two things are there, right? Okay, so everyone are able to see two things, right? Cells and crystals. I need not say which are these. So these are your crystals, right? We will learn about what are the different types of crystals. But I hope now you are clear that what is the difference between a cell, a cast, and a crystal, right? Now, one more question is, which type of cell is these? These are RBC cells, right? A lot of you have referred, yes. Triple phosphate crystal cells are there. Yes, it is also correct. We will learn about the crystals. RBCs are there. Now see, two different things are there. RBCs can be of two types. They may be isomorphic. That is, all RBC are normal in shape as do their original. That is, they are biconcave. Isomorphic. That is, maintained their shape and size. Size might be not a factor, but shape is important, right? Isomorphic means they have maintained their shape. While see this image. In this, you can see that some of the RBC have maintained, so they are isomorphic, while some, their shape has damaged, so they are called as dysmorphic. They are dysmorphic RBC. What is important to understand is that there are different conditions in which isomorphic and dysmorphic RBCs are seen in urine. If it is a glomerular disorder, right? See, again, if there is problem in the glomerular basement membrane, filtering mein hi problem hai. So RBCs will get deformed while passing through the glomerulus. So in case of any glomerular disorder, what do we see? We see dysmorphic RBCs. These are seen in glomerular disorder. Right? While isomorphic RBCs, they are any pathology after glomerulus. So in case of tubulointerstitial disease, in any case of tubulointerstitial disease, we get to see isomorphic RBCs. So remember, friends, okay? Dysmorphic RBCs, glomerular disorders, isomorphic RBCs, tubular disorders. This is an important concept. Now, crystals, right? We know there are different types of crystals that are seen. Now, this will be asked to you in your university exam practical to draw the crystals. You might say uric acid crystals, triple phosphate crystals is envelope shaped, then calcium carbonate crystals are dumbbell shaped. So I'm not going into detail over here. I'll just tell you triple phosphate envelope like, so you can see this is an envelope like structure is there, right? Then calcium carbonate is dumbbell shape is there. These are given in your journals. Make sure you know how to draw them and in which conditions they are seen, right? I'm not going into detail. Our main part is histology, which is the next part, okay? So we start with renal histology. Okay, so first, this is the basic normal histology that we see. Normal renal histology or kidney biopsy that we see. So what do we see over here? This is your glomerulus, right? What are these? These are your tubules. It may be PCT, it may be DCT, anything. That is basically cross section is there. So they are your tubules. And what is this central part? I'll highlight with another color. What is this? These are your blood vessels. Okay. So this is your blood vessel that we see. Three main things are there. Glomerulus is there. Blood vessels are there and tubules are there, right? This is normal histology. I hope now you will be able to easily identify the basic renal histology and not make a mistake that this is a slide of kidney. Okay, let us start. Now we know that in kidney pathology, basically there will be two types of main disorders. One is your nephritic syndrome, another is your nephrotic syndrome. And in various things, we have different types of deposits that are seen, right? Four main type of deposits, subepithelial. Let us go into the glomerular basement ultrastructure of glomerulus. See this lower image first. We have the epithelium is there, right? Glomerular basement membrane is there. So these are your epithelial cells uppermost. Then we have the glomerular basement membrane is there. And then we have the endothelial cell at the lowest part. Subepithelial. If it is present above the epithelium, or we can say along with the epithelium, somewhere over here, it is called as your subepithelial humps. Okay? Epimembranous. Epimembranous basically means intra or inside the membrane. So if it is found inside the glomerular basement membrane, it is called as epimembranous deposits. Third, subendothelial deposits. If it is found below, I cannot go down deep over here, but somewhere over here. If it is found below the endothelium, it is called as your subendothelial deposits are seen. And mesangial deposits. We know that mesangial cells have a capillary cells are the supporting cells of the kidney. So if they are found inside the between the mesangiums, mesangial cells, ke beech mein paya jata hai, they are called as mesangial deposits. We will learn the conditions in which they are seen. So these four things you need to know the basic: subepithelial, subendothelial, epimembranous or intramembranous, and mesangial deposits as in IgA nephropathy. We will learn the conditions. So let us first start with nephritic syndrome, right? We all know basic what are the clinical features of a nephritic syndrome. So I'm not going into that thing. Let us first start with the first condition that is most commonly called as PSGN, that is post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis. What kind of epithelial deposits are seen in case of this thing? Okay, answer. What kind of deposits are seen in case of post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis? Yes, correct. It is subepithelial deposits are seen. Okay. Now, tell me, can you see the subepithelial deposits in this slide? This is the right-hand side image is there. Mesangioproliferative is written, right? Can you see the subepithelial deposits in this image? How many of you can see? I want to first know that कितने लोग पढ़ के आए हैं और देख सकते हो इसके. I'll zoom in, right? If it is, see, how many of you can see the subepithelial deposits in this? Just send yes on the chat box if you are able to see the subepithelial deposits. Good. I had got a very nice answer once that yes, I can see subepithelial deposits on H&E staining of light microscopy. So take care. You cannot see subepithelial deposits on light microscopy. Yes, it is only seen in case of electron microscopy. So what do we see in case of light microscopy? We see mesangial proliferations. Cells are proliferating. Now, how will we be able to see that thing? It is only possible if we compare the normal with the mesangial proliferative cells, right? Light microscopy in kidney is rarely asked for nephritic or nephrotic syndrome, right? So you can see the density. Yahan pe normal ke andar density less hai. While in case of mesangium proliferative, dikh raha hai. Mesangium has proliferated. So this is the characteristic appearance seen in case of light microscopy. But don't worry, ye nahi image diye jayega tumhe exam ke andar, right? Second thing, what do we see is increased cellularity in the glomerulus, reduced Bowman spaces. This is also वेरी कैरेक्टरिस्टिक कि ये एक ग्लोमेरुलस था, राइट? यहाँ पे इंक्रीज सेल्स बढ़ गए हैं, ओके. जस्ट इन केस रेयरली कभी पूछ लिया तो, बाकी नॉट आस्क्ड. दिस इज व्हाट इज आस्क्ड इन केस ऑफ दिस कंडीशंस. वी नो दैट सब एपिथेलियल डिपॉजिट है, सो व्हाट विल इट लुक लाइक ऑन इम्यूनोफ्लोरोसेंस? ग्रैन्यूलर डिपॉजिट्स. अब इस इमेज में देख सकते हो, इट इज नॉट स्मूथ. आई विल शो यू ईच ऑफ देम. सो दीज आर योर ग्रैन्यूलर इम्यूनोफ्लोरोसेंस डिपॉजिट्स सीन इन केस ऑफ पीएसजीएन, पोस्ट स्ट्रेप्टोकोकल ग्लोमेरुलोनेफ्राइटिस. ओके, राइट? दिस इज द अपीयरेंस दैट वी सी ऑन इम्यूनोफ्लोरोसेंस. नाउ दिस इज अ स्लाइड व्हिच यू नीड which you all need to understand. अगर एग्जाम में क्वेश्चन आता है तो यही क्वेश्चन पूछते हैं. सब एपिथेलियल डिपॉजिट्स, हैव अ लुक एट दीज स्ट्रक्चर्स. व्हाट आर दे? दे आर योर सब एपिथेलियल डिपॉजिट्स, ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज योर हम्स, राइट? सब एंड जो हम्स बोलते हैं इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोपी के अंदर, व्हाट आर दे? दीज आर बेसिकली दीज ब्लैक स्ट्रक्चर्स विच वी सी, इवन दिस which you can see, this is your subepithelial deposits, also called as your humps. Okay, one more thing I forgot to tell you about this thing. What do we call this thing as? It is called as starry sky appearance, right? Starry sky appearance. Ek dark night may, if you see there are bright stars, you see something like this. Now a question for you all. We all know that starry sky appearance in kidney is seen in case of PSGN, but if it is seen in case of lymph node, what is that condition, or in which condition of lymph node is starry sky appearance seen? Yes, correct. So, okay, so two things are there. One is starry sky appearance on renal or renal biopsy is PSGN. And if it is in lymph node, it is seen in case of Burkitt's lymphoma. Perfect. I think this was a previous year question. Burkitt's lymphoma. Okay. Okay. So let us now jump to next topic. So we know these are the humps, subepithelial humps that are seen in case of post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis. Now, second question, what is this? Identify. This is a spotter which can be easily identified. Easy. Okay, answer everyone. This is a very simple slide. Yes, almost everyone is correct. Yes, this is rapidly proliferative glomerulonephritis, RPGN. And what do we see in it? We see crescents. Now let us identify these crescents. See, I'm highlighting this part. See, this is the crescent that you can see. Same thing like this, right? This is a crescent. This is the normal part. So don't make a mistake. And this is your crescent. Similarly, normal and crescent. So this is in a condition RPGN, rapidly progressive glomerulonephritis. Now we know that there are three different types of RPGN, type 1, 2, and 3. And we know what are the different features that are seen in this case. In type 1, what do we see? They are anti-glomerular basement disorders, right? So in type 1, it is against the glomerular basement membrane. Now, glomerular basement membrane is a constituted, it is a continuous thing there. There is not a deposit, nahi hai. Ek thoda hai, fir thoda hai, nahi hai, waisa nahi hai. It is a continuous structure. So agar antibodies against glomerular basement membrane is formed, how will it appear? It will appear linear, right? So in type 1, what do we have? We have linear immunofluorescence. In case of type 2, what do we have? That is against a particular structure, right? Immune complex deposition hota hai type 2 ke andar, seen in IgA nephropathy, SL is there, whatever, etc. So what is this? It will show you granular appearance, as you see in MPGN. So type 2 will have granular appearance. Okay, and in type 3, what will be that of immunofluorescence? No immunofluorescence. No immunofluorescence in case of type 3. Okay, that is posi immune RPGN is there. Okay, now one more question is there. What will be the treatment of type 1 RPGN? If someone can answer, what will be the treatment of type 1 RPGN? Yes, correct. It will be plasmapheresis. Antibodies are there. So plasmapheresis use karte. We all know about dialysis. Vaisa hi ek hota hai procedure. Jisme se antibodies specifically remove kar diye jate. But remember, this is not to be done in type 2 and type 3 because type 2 ke andar antigen antibody form ho chuka hai, immune complex ban chuka hai. So you cannot remove an antibody from an antigen antibody complex. Isliye type 2 ke andar plasmapheresis is not useful. Okay. Similarly, type 3 ke andar, kyunki wahan pe to antibody hai hi nahi. So we cannot use it over there. Okay, now what is this? See, don't diagnose the condition. Bahut sare conditions mein se dikha raha hai. I want just you to answer. Jo tumhe black arrows se jo dikhaya gaya hai, what does it indicate? Usko pathology ke bhasha mein kya kahenge hum? Usko hum log, I don't have words, I'm wrong words to say this thing. Okay, let me answer it. Okay, see, basically, the point I was asking was, this is mesangial proliferation. जैसे मैंने उसमें कहा था mesangial proliferation. Proliferation. Okay. What type of condition is this? This is IgA nephropathy. See, I am not giving a clinical case over here. Agar clinical case diya hota hai, and if there is mesangial proliferation that is seen, it will be seen mostly in case of IgA nephropathy. Okay. This is rarely asked, so don't worry about it. Nothing important. Now, nephrotic syndrome. Second part. Okay. A 5-year-old child presented to you with some urinary problems or something is there. You order a renal biopsy, and this is the image that we see, right? The patient had typical symptoms of nephrotic syndrome, and on renal biopsy, this image is seen. What is your diagnosis? Yes, correct. So this is minimal change disease. Ye normal hi hai. What do we see? This is your minimal change disease. In which light microscopy is normal. Worst cases में हम क्या देख सकते हैं? lipoid nephrosis. Right? If I'm just lipoid nephrosis, what is it basically? It is the tubular cells deposit lipid into the interstitium of the cells, giving it a little bit of foamy appearance. That is called as your lipoid nephrosis. Okay. Now, second, what is the characteristic thing that we see on electron microscopy in case of minimal change disease? Characteristic appearance kya dikhta hai of on electron microscopy of kidney biopsy of a minimal change disease? Yes, flat podocyte or effacement of podocyte. Okay, so ek concept tha ke effacement of damaged podocytes, that is fusion of podocytes. No, fusion nahi hota hai. Effacements mein wo flatten ho jaate hai. So let us see, this is a normal image and this is minimal change disease. So what do we see? ये जो सारे structures आप देख रहे हो, what are they? They are your podocytes. And what do we see in case of minimal change disease? That they all have flattened. Effacement उनका हो चुका है. So this is your effacement of podocyte seen in case of minimal change disease. And immunofluorescence के ऊपर हमें कुछ नहीं मिलेगा because immune complex deposition नहीं होता है. So minimal change disease अगर diagnose करना है तो electron microscopy पे ही होता है. Light microscopy is normal. Okay, this is also the same image. You can see over here. Effacement of podocytes. Okay, this is what I was telling about lipoid nephrosis, lipid deposit. Okay, and on immunofluorescence, we get nothing. No immunofluorescence. What is the disease that we see? This is your minimal change disease. Okay, so all microscopic findings on a single slide. Let us move ahead. Okay. Now, what is this? Try to diagnose. Nephrotic syndrome ka hi ek part hai. This, I hope utna to tumhe hint mil gayi hogi. Yes. So, this is focal segmental glomerulonephrosis. FSGN. FSGS, right? Glomerulosclerosis. So there are two things are there. Ek, agar if I take a entire slide and there are many glomerulus on it, wo hame low power pe dikhega. This is a high power. So what do we see? Focal segmental. Matlab pura nahi, sirf some. Only few focal glomeruli are damaged. So wo hame kaha milega? Low microscopy image ke andar. This is a high magnification. So that is focal. And within a single glomerulus also, only some part is involved. This is called as your segmental. Only a segment. See, interchangeably use kar sakte ho. Focal पार्ट ऑफ दी ग्लोमेरुलस एंड ओनली अ सेगमेंट ऑफ ग्लोमेरुलाई आर इन्वॉल्व, वो भी यूज कर सकते हो. मेन एम इज दैट अमंगस्ट ऑल ग्लोमेरुलाई सम आर इन्वॉल्व एंड इवन अमंगस्ट अ सिंगल ग्लोमेरुलाई ओनली अ स्मॉल पार्ट इज इन्वॉल्व, दैट इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज FSGS, फोकल सेगमेंटल ग्लोमेरुलोस्क्लेरोसिस. सिंगल स्लाइड, ओके, इजी टू डायग्नोस. नाउ ट्राई टू आइडेंटिफाई दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोपी. सी, इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोपी के जो भी क्वेश्चन होंगे ना, उसमें दे विल गिव यू दिस इज एन इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोपी इमेज ऑफ अ रीनल और समथिंग, मतलब जो भी ऑर्गन का है वो देंगे. यू कैनॉट आइडेंटिफाई एन ऑर्गन ऑन इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोपी एज सच. Try to identify what the clinical, what is the characteristic thing which I want to make you show. ये सारी चीजें आप लोगों ने अपने notebooks में लिखी तो है, right? But you have never seen this thing. I want the thing that is seen. ये क्या है? कौन सा appearance? I don't want a diagnosis. Diagnosis नहीं चाहिए इसके केस में. Membranous nephropathy है, glomerulopathy है, okay, fine, कोई problem नहीं, but I want क्या appearance दिख रहा है. As we have seen, foot effacement of podocyte is seen is there, फिर सब epithelial या सब endothelial humps है, whatever है, क्या दिख रहा है. Okay, now if I say you, okay, Abu Dhabi कोई लोग गए होंगे तो ऐसा कुछ देखा है? इस पैटर्न को क्या कहते हैं? व्हाट इज दिस पैटर्न कॉल्ड? यस, डोम एंड स्पाइक और स्पाइक एंड डोम अपीयरेंस. मैंने बोला था ये तुम लोग ने लिखा है बट यू हैव नेवर सीन इट, स्पाइक एंड डोम. सो दिस इज द सेम थिंग दैट वी सी ओवर हियर. लेट अस सी इट. जो जैसा बोलते हैं वैसे कभी दिखता नहीं है. सो दिस is your spike and dome appearance that is seen, right? ये black color के जो deposits है और उसके बीच में spiking जो दिखाया गया. So what is this condition? We all know this, right? It is seen in case of membranous glomerulopathy, one of the important cause of nephrotic syndrome in elderly people. So this is the subepithelial deposits जो होते हैं giving rise to spike and dome appearance of basement membrane. Okay? Right, so I'll write it down. I hope MG is fine, membranous glomerulopathy. Now, what is this that you can see? अब क्या characteristic feature तुम्हें दिख रहा है? Again, I'll say ये चीज आपने लिखी है. किसी और ने लिख दिया, मतलब मैं नहीं लिखूं वैसा नहीं, तुम्हें आता है तो लिखो. यस, करेक्ट. दिस इज द स्प्लिटिंग ऑफ बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन. ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज योर ट्राम ट्रैक अपीयरेंस. What is the condition in which it is seen? You can see this is the one and this is the second, right? So these two, the basement membrane appears to be split. And what is the condition it is seen? Yes, membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis, correct. MPGN is the condition in which this is seen. Okay, membrane of proliferative disease, splitting of the basement membrane. Correct. It is of two types, type 1, type 2. And we are not much concerned. Type 2 can there, mostly it is seen on triumph tract appearance. Okay. Now, this is something nice. ये क्वेश्चन आया है, नथिंग एल्स इज गिवन, डायग्नोस द कंडीशन, व्हाट विल बी योर आंसर. आई एम नॉट गोइंग इनटू द पैथोलॉजी ऑफ दिस कंडीशन. करेक्ट. आई वांट एवरीवन टू आंसर. याद रखोगे आंसर, दिस इज एस एल ई. ओके, इस इफेक्ट को क्या कहते हैं एंड व्हाई इज इट कॉल्ड एज दिस इफेक्ट. ओके, लिखा है फुल हाउस इफेक्ट. ओके, दिस कंडीशन इज कॉल्ड एज फुल हाउस इफेक्ट. समझाता हूँ क्यों. आई वांट फर्स्ट आंसर फ्रॉम यू ऑल, व्हाई इज इट कॉल्ड एज फुल हाउस इफेक्ट. एनीवन, आई लॉन्ग एक्सप्लेनेशन है, सो आई विल वेट वन मिनट इफ समवन इज टाइपिंग. व्हाई इज इट कॉल्ड एज फुल हाउस इफेक्ट, बिकॉज एवरीथिंग लाइट्स अप, पूरा घर जगमगान लगा वैसा. डिपॉजिट्स अर्थ ऑफ IgA, IgM एंड मेनी द ऑन कॉम्प्लीमेंट एंटीबॉडी प्रोटीन्स. फुल हाउस होता क्या है, जो लोग पत्ते बहुत खेलते हैं उनको पता होना चाहिए. व्हाट इज फुल हाउस. हाउस का घर के साथ कोई कनेक्शन नहीं. इट इज समथिंग टू रिलेट विद कार्ड्स. कार्ड्स के साथ कनेक्शन है. दिस माइट बी अ यू नो, इफ दे वांट टू रियली ट्विस्ट इट ना, वो तुम्हें कार्ड्स का फोटो दे सकते हैं कि कार्ड्स होते हैं एंड दे मे गिव यू सम रीनल पैथोलॉजी एसोसिएटेड विद इट. ओके, सी डिफिकल्ट होगा अगर जानना. फुल हाउस इन कार्ड्स मतलब 3 ace विथ 2 king. इस कंडीशन को हम लोग कहते हैं फुल हाउस इन केस ऑफ कार्ड्स. So what do we see over here? Exactly, देखो, we have IgG, IgA and IgM. 3 antibodies, okay, and C3 complement, C1q complement, and 2 complement proteins are there, right? So 3 antibodies plus 2 complement proteins, if all are present in deposited in the kidney, that condition as similar to the condition of full house in of cards, that is 3 ace and 2 kings, right? So this is called as full house effect seen in case of SLE, systemic lupus erythematosus. जो renal के अंदर कौन सी condition को बोला जाता है, lupus nephritis, right? Lupus nephritis. Okay. Now what is the other thing that is seen in case of lupus nephritis of the kidney? Lupus nephritis of the kidney shows one more thing. What is it? Yes, membranous nephropathy is fine, but my answer, yes. The correct answer is wire loop lesions. I don't know if it is called as thumbprint appearance. Mujhe pata nahi, it might be there. I don't know. I'm not saying usually. So wire loop lesions. What are wire loop lesions? Ek wire loop kya hota hai? This is a type of wire loop. Isko wire loop kehte hain. So wire loop is homogeneous and rigid thickening of the peripheral capillary loops. So periphery ke andar jo capillary loops hote hain, wo proliferate kar jate hain aur thickened ho jate hain, giving it a typical. ये आप देख सकते हो यहाँ पे वायर लूप लेशन, पेरिफेरी की जो होगी वो तुम्हें मिलते हैं. अगेन एल से इतनी कैरेक्टरिस्टिक स्लाइड नहीं है, दिस विल ओनली बी आस्क्ड एज अ थ्योरेटिकल क्वेश्चन. वायर लूप लेशन विल बी सीन इन केस ऑफ SLE, ल्यूपस नेफ्राइटिस. ओके, नेक्स्ट. सो ओके, नेक्स्ट, डायग्नोस दिस कंडीशन. अगर कर सकोगे या फिर मैं फिर केस देता हूँ तुम्हें, केस लूंगा तो तुरंत पता चल जाएगा. ट्राई टू आइडेंटिफाई दिस कंडीशन. गेस मारो, कुछ भी क्या दिख रहा है, लीजन को डिस्क्राइब करो, देन आल्सो इट इज फाइन. डिफिकल्ट है अगर विदाउट मैं केस दूंगा, बट अगर मैं केस दे दूंगा तो तुम तुरंत आइडेंटिफाई कर दोगे. बोलो। यस, अब तो आंसर बताओ। 56-year-old फीमेल विथ हिस्ट्री ऑफ टाइप 2 डायबिटीज मेलाइटस प्रेजेंट्स द फॉलोइंग बायोप्सी, व्हाट लीजन्स आर सीन? यस करेक्ट, इट इज के डब्ल्यू लीजन्स, दैट इज काइमल स्टेन विल्सन लीजन्स दैट आर सीन। के डब्ल्यू लीजन्स, काइमल स्टेन विल्सन लीजन्स, ये जो आप देख रहे हो, दे आर एरियाज ऑफ नोड्यूलर स्क्लेरोसिस बिकॉज ऑफ एन ग्लाइकेटेड एंड प्रोडक्ट्स जो होते हैं डायबिटीज में लॉन्ग टर्म में, दैट विल बी गेट विल गेट डिपॉजिटेड इन टू द ग्लोमेरुलस गिविंग इट अ नोड्यूलर अपीरियंस सीन इन के ऑल्सो नेचर के डब्ल्यू लीजन्स, काइमल स्टेन विल्सन लीजन्स। ओके सिंपल। ओके, टाइप टू डायबिटीज मेलिटस। नेक्स्ट, ये नहीं आया ना तो आई वॉन्ट दैट पर्सन टू लीव दिस ग्रुप इमीजिएटली। कंडीशन डायग्नोस नहीं कर पाए चलेगा, स्टेन आइडेंटिफाई करके मुझे दो। आई एम नॉट गिविंग एनी हिस्ट्री, केस स्टडी में नहीं दे रहा हूं। कंडीशन नहीं आता है चलेगा, स्टेन एटलीस्ट मुझे आइडेंटिफाई करो। जो कंडीशन कर सकते हो दैट इज वेरी गुड, एटलीस्ट स्टेन बताओ। आई वॉन्ट एवरी वन टू आंसर। हाउ मेनी पीपल आर देयर? 60 पीपल आर देयर। यस करेक्ट, सो दिस इज अमाइलोइडोसिस। Amyloid deposition is seen and the stain is congruent. Okay, very simple, reddish color appearance दिखता है amyloid, it's deposited in the kidney and I hope you all remember apple green is the birefringence that is seen in case of polarized microscopy and not the color. Okay, apple green is not the stain color, it is the birefringence that is seen. नेक्स्ट, आई वॉन्ट एवरी, अगर कोई थर्ड ईयर स्टूडेंट मेरा बैचमेट इधर कोई बैठा है, इफ इट इज सीइंग दिस दिस आई वॉन्ट हिम और हर टू आंसर दिस स्लाइड। ये स्लाइड के बिना तुम्हारा सेकेंड ईयर एमबीबीएस की प्रैक्टिकल एग्जामिनेशन पास नहीं होने वाली है। आई वॉन्ट दैट पर्सन रदर ही शी वॉट एवर जो भी देख रहा है my batchmate, I want him or her to answer and others also try. And I am giving you guarantee, ये स्लाइड के बिना आपकी थर्ड सेकेंड ईयर एम बी बी एस की यूनिवर्सिटी एग्जाम खत्म नहीं होने वाली है। Yes, correct. So this is a slide of CPN, that is chronic pyelonephritis. How is it diagnose kaise karenge? We see what thyroidization of tubules, thyroidization of tubules is seen. Characteristically found in CPN, thyroid ke jaisa wo cheeze dikhti hai. So this is the condition of thyroidization of globules seen in case of chronic pyelonephritis. ये गलती मत करना। I am 100% sure ये slide मैं जो बहुत सारे लोगों को, this is a frequently asked slide in your examination, right? So easy spot diagnosis है, गलती मत करना। What is this? Okay, एक मिनट, एक काम करो, पहले try to answer this. What is this? 1 minute, let it, okay. Try to identify this condition, उसके बाद हम लोग वहां जाएंगे। First, identify this. See, ये एक characteristic slide है, और किधर नहीं मिलेगी वैसी कुछ slide. This is a slide of renal cell carcinoma. Now, there are various types of renal cell carcinoma and this type is your clear cell. आप देख सकते हो ये cells are clear, transparent cells है यहाँ पे, right? Clearly देख सकते हो. So this is a slide of clear cell carcinoma, clear cell variant of renal cell carcinoma. Okay, now try to identify this. At least basic condition मुझे बताओ. ओके आई होप एटलीस्ट जो आंसर नहीं कर पा रहे नॉट अ कोई बात नहीं, आराम से हो जाएगा. बट एटलीस्ट कैन यू बोल सकते हो कि ये नॉर्मल कंडीशन नहीं है और ये कार्सिनोमा हो सकता है. इतना तुम्हें आइडेंटिफाई करना आना चाहिए कि आप हाइपरक्रोमेसिया के हिसाब से बोल सकते हो दिस इज अ कंडीशन ऑफ मैलिग्नेंसी. प्लस GIT की अगर आई हैव नॉट येट टॉट GIT बट GIT की स्लाइड्स देख के आप बोल सकते हो GIT या फिर इवन नियोप्लेसिया की स्लाइड्स देख के कि देयर इज पैपिलरी फॉर्मेशन दैट इज फिंगर लाइक प्रोजेक्शंस आर सीन. सी ओके सो टू थिंग्स आर देयर. वन पैपिलरी मतलब फिंगर लाइक प्रोजेक्शंस है एंड मैलिग्नेंसी है. आई एम टेलिंग दिस इज अ स्लाइड ऑफ रीनल. आपको हिस्ट्री में कुछ ना कुछ हिंट दिया होगा कि ये रीनल की स्लाइड है. तो दिस इज ऑल्सो अ स्लाइड ऑफ आरसीसी एंड व्हाट इज द वेरिएंट दिस इज पैपिलरी टाइप ऑफ आरसीसी. पैपिलरी टाइप ऑफ आरसीसी रीनल सेल कार्सिनोमा एंड दिस स्लाइड. ओके नाउ कैन यू आइडेंटिफाई व्हाट इज दिस स्लाइड लास्ट स्लाइड एंड वी एंड. Yes, so this is also RCC and what is the variant? Chromophobe. Small cells are seen, darkly chromophobe. देख सकते हो small cells, round cells जो बोलते हैं small cell variant that are getting deposited plant like chromophobe. Yes, correct. They are getting deposited into the glomerulus, interstitium and such other things giving it malignancy like appearance of dekh sakte ho hyperchromasia se. So this ends our session on histopathology of renal system. Now if you have any doubts feel free to ask.